Hi, welcome to Inside Singapore. I'm Jamie Yeo and you're watching Inside TV. Coming up on the show this month,
explore one of Singapore's most vibrant shopping malls, find out where to get the best pint of the black stuff, laugh until you cry at the city's top comedy theatre show, and find out what there is to eat, drink, and discover in Asia's most dynamic city-state.
For all this and more, stay right here on Inside Singapore.
Coming up, we'll cover everything from the city's colorful history and vibrant culture to its diverse attractions and the remarkable shopping opportunities that have made it world famous for retail therapy. And once the sun goes down, we'll explore the incredible choice of dining and nightlife options that have made Singapore the most happening city in Southeast Asia. Singapore is well known for its unique blend of historical buildings and cutting-edge modern design. The skyscrapers of the CBD tower over well-preserved colonial structures like the old post office, the Asian Civilizations Museum, and the colorful riverside shophouses of Boat and Clark Quays, now lively nightlife centers. No building is more iconic than Raffles Hotel, if only to try the world-famous Singapore Sling where it was first invented.
A short stroll away, you'll find the Asian Civilizations Museum and the Old Parliament House, now named the Arts House.
Occupying the almost 200-year-old building that was the original home to Singapore's Parliament, the Arts House is the spiritual home for Singapore's vibrant art scene, playing host to literary arts, film, performing, and visual arts and festivals. Overlooking Boat Quay, a statue of Sir Stamford Raffles pays tribute to its establishment of the area as a port in the early 1800s. The Kavanagh Bridge, a vital link to the flourishing river trade at the time, is still standing, making it the oldest bridge in Singapore.
Preparations are underway for the Singapore Airlines International Cup, here at the Singapore Turf Club, happening over the third weekend in May. The Singapore Airlines International Cup, or SIA Cup, attracts the finest racehorses from around the world. A race prize of $3 million Singapore dollars is up for grabs for the winner. The race will be run over 2,000 meters long, or approximately 10 furlongs, with a maximum of 16 starters under the night skies in Kranji. A magnificent setting for a world-class horse racing event. The Singapore Airlines International Cup is a yearly challenge of the best middle-distance horses and their talented jockeys in the world. The first racehorse to ever win the SIA Cup was a New Zealand-bred and locally trained horse called Uzo. Within just 2 years, the Singapore Airlines International Cup was awarded the International Group 1 status, the highest race grade accorded around the world. Since then, winners have come from a good spread of countries. For those interested in witnessing the spectacle that is the SIA Cup, there are two packages available for the event. The Gold Card Room package sells at $140, while the Party at the Lawn package, where you can view the action trackside, is priced at $240. Both packages are inclusive of light tea and a buffet dinner. Come deck out smartly and enjoy a day at the races at the Singapore Airlines International Cup this May.
Imagine an 18-hole championship golf course located right smack in the center of Singapore with amazing views of our iconic cityscape, be it day or night.
The award-winning Marina Bay Golf Course features a unique 4-tier driving range to practice your swing.
This golf course has quite a few challenging holes, especially my favorite, the iconic Par 3 13th hole.
Characteristic of the links-styled course is the pot bunker, and there are 91 pot bunkers to look out for at Marina Bay Golf Course.
After a hard day's work, my favorite after-golf activities are a quick foot massage at Energy Bay and a sumptuous dinner at the Canopy Cafe. This is a great way to complete your golfing day.
One Altitude and One Raffles Place is situated in one of the most convenient locations in the city. perched atop Singapore's tallest building and just a few steps from Raffles Place MRT.
One Altitude offers a great daytime deal for tourists. Just pick up a ticket here at the ground level of One Raffles Place and get a great guided tour of Singapore's highest viewing deck.
On the way up, check out the view over the bay as you're whisked to the 63rd floor where your tour begins. An experienced guide will walk you through Singapore's best landmarks from the city's only 360-degree viewing deck with fantastic views over Marina Bay, the ocean, and the city.
And afterwards, move downstairs to the two-star restaurant Stella, where executive chef Chris Miller serves up a great value fine dining lunch menu.
Stella's lunch menu features an impressive selection of Western and Japanese cuisine.
But for me, nothing beats their dessert buffet. It's a showcase of sweet treats from cakes to pastries to more refined seasonal delights.
One Altitude's daytime deal is available only by purchasing a ticket at the ground floor of One Raffles Place. To find out more, check out onealtitude.com.
If you want to start your visit to Singapore on a high, Faber Peak Singapore is a must visit. Take a scenic joyride on board the Singapore cable car. Nothing beats the thrill of taking off in your own cable car and having a bird's eye view of the world below. Plus, you'll get a chance to spend the day with your favorite DC superheroes.
Linking Mount Faber and the island resort Sentosa, it's the only cable car in the world that goes over a lush greenery and a highway, through an office building, over a cruise bay, and onto an island. Before boarding, get the most out of your trip at Mount Faber by kicking off the day with a happy drill. Start with getting a pair of wishing bells from the gift shop, pen your wishes, and tie them at the Garden of Happy Promises. Stop by Spurts and Aprons and savor delectable dishes while soaking in breathtaking views of Singapore from the top of Mount Faber.
I'm all ready for my cable car joyride.
Before you board the cable car, download this free app, Fly with the Superheroes. See your favorite DC superhero appear right alongside you using clever augmented reality and take awesome pictures with your hero as you fly on the Singapore cable car.
Don your free mask and ride with the DC superheroes in four specially themed Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman and Green Lantern cabins on your journey to Sentosa.
Enjoy the best seats in town to catch a 360-degree visual treat of the lush greenery of Mount Faber Park, Singapore's city skyline, harbourfront, Sentosa Island, and Resort World Sentosa. Don't forget to spot the dolphins swimming below too.
I'm here on sunny Sentosa at the newest beach location in town, aptly named Seaside. This is an ideal one-stop destination for those people who love lazy days spent in the sun, surrounded by delicious food, wonderful drinks, and fun company. There are five different outlets here, each offering everything you need for a fun day out in the sun. There are two bars at Seaside to choose from, the laid-back sandbar and the legendary Bikini Bar, already a Singaporean beach bar institution. At Bikini Bar, there is always a party going on, with classic rock hits, ice-cold beers, and live sport action. When you come to Sentosa, make sure your first stop is Sandbar here on Siloso Beach.
You can't miss Sandbar. Check out the landmark bamboo art structure, handcrafted by renowned Indonesian artist Joko Avianto. It's a sight to behold, and the first thing you'll see when you get down to Siloso Beach.
They've got a great range of drinks here, from soft drinks to ice-cold beer to cocktails. My favorite is their signature strawberry mojito. Backing up the bars are three casual eateries to choose from, Coast, Flame, and Makan Makan.
And when you get hungry, worry not. The flavorful aromas of roasted meats from Flame fill the air.
It's a haven for meat lovers. Today, I'm having their famous Flame platter and their signature flat iron steak. Which one first?
And end the day on the beach with great music from local artists every Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and public holidays while the ocean twinkles in the background.
Today, I am going to show you how you can fly.
In your first lesson, you should be able to fly for a little while above the water, but it takes a bit more time before you get the skills to do more complicated maneuvers like Alfred. If you like adrenaline thrills, you'll definitely love this. I think I'll just watch for now. Looks really fun though. I'll definitely try this next time.
Bars, pools, luxury shopping, a spa, fine dining restaurants. This might sound like a luxury hotel or resort, but the best thing about this particular hotel, it floats.
Lay Asia's largest cruise ship, the Royal Caribbean's Mariner of the Seas, on its side, and it would tower over every building in Singapore.
Join our insider Sonia as she gives you the lowdown on what Asia's largest cruise ship has to offer.
Well, my first preconception has just been blown out of the water. No pun intended. The room is way bigger than I expected, with even a cozy bed, a dressing area, and a sitting area. But there's far too much to explore to hang around here. Let's go see what there is to do on board. I know, cliche to start with shopping, but I was too excited about the promise of a promenade on board a ship. Check out these shophouse facades.
If you're thinking you won't have enough to do while you're at sea, worry not. The ship is a treasure trove of things to do, from shopping to mini golf and even ice skating.
I'm not exactly a pro when it comes to rock climbing, but how many chances in life do you get to climb a wall over the ocean?
All right, well, I did my best. Fortunately, I had my friend Laura to help me out, but now I'm famished.
The ship has a whole range of restaurants, bars, and cafes serving everything from fusion buffet to fine dining options. I opted for the fine dining restaurant, where a table is reserved for every passenger every night.
I'll be completely honest, I really wasn't expecting much, but I'm really surprised. This is quite delicious.
But my day aboard the Mariner of the Seas isn't over yet. There's an exciting lineup of evening entertainment that promises to keep going into the wee hours.
But what I'm really excited about is catching the Ice Spectacular, a live show performed on the first ever ice rink at sea. Royal Caribbean's Ice Spectacular features professional skaters from all over the world.
My day on board Mariner of the Seas has been nothing short of perfect. And I got to meet the captain himself, and even Kung Fu Panda. Mariner of the Seas truly offers something for everyone. For more information on cruises leaving from Singapore, check out the Royal Caribbean website.
Adrenaline junkies and adventure seekers, the mega zip here on Sentosa Island is where you want to be. And I recommend you spend the entire morning here because there's just so much to do. You could rock climb, which is what we call the north face, or you could do climax, which is an entire obstacle course that involves lots of climbing. And then there is the para jumping, which is a bit like jumping out of a plane. And last but not the least, there is the mega zip, which I just cannot wait to try today. Gosh, that was amazing. At first, I was a bit nervous at the top when I saw, you know, the tops of all the trees and everything, but then it got really cool, and I tell you, that was a real adrenaline rush. I'm gonna do it again. Yes, I'm gonna do it again. I'm gonna do it again. If you're looking for something adrenaline pumping and exciting for the family, check out the Skyline Luge Sentosa. It's so fun, once is never enough. Now, there are two trails, the Jungle and the Dragon Trail. Apparently a pro can take about a minute. I'm gonna try to do it in 3 minutes. See ya! This was so much fun. The luge ride down was really exciting, but taking the sky ride up, totally relaxing. To the left, to the left. That was so awesome. The fun doesn't stop when the sun goes down because as you can see, even at night, the track is lit beautifully. I'm gonna do it again.
You're watching Insider TV, the insider's guide to the world's most exciting cities.
I'm here at Sentosa 4D Adventureland, one of Sentosa's most popular attractions, where you can have fun, whatever the weather.
Located within easy distance of Sentosa's Island Transport, just a quick walk from India Lookout, this dynamic attraction is not just a fantastic escape from the tropical sun or a passing rain shower, it's a thrilling adventure for the whole family. With modern state-of-the-art theatres, customers can choose from three exciting experiences: Extreme Log Ride, Journey to the Mysterious Island, and Desperados.
If you like adrenaline thrills, you should try Extreme Log Ride, a high-speed adventure that has you speeding on a virtual roller coaster ride through the jungle, all in super realistic 4D high definition. For a bit of gunslinging fun, don't miss Desperados, where you can saddle up and take on a gang of outlaws in a fast-paced interactive shootout.
Journey to the Mysterious Island is equally impressive, taking viewers on an immersive adventure that includes wind, water, and amazingly realistic special effects. Entry tickets to Sentosa 4D Adventureland include access to all the rides here and with unlimited admissions for the whole day with free entry for children under 3. So if you're looking for a truly unforgettable 4D experience, check out the Sentosa 4D Adventureland. You won't regret it. Explore the world's best rainforest zoo right here in Singapore. With many award-winning exhibits and shows, the fun never ends at the Singapore Zoo. Discover a colorful paradise at the world's largest bird park. Jurong Bird Park houses over 5,000 birds across 380 species, one of the largest collections of birds in the world. Escape into the world of drama and mystery at the night safari. As dusk falls, come up close to over 1,000 nocturnal animals and catch a rare glimpse into their nightly rituals. Ever wonder what it's like to drive a Ferrari around an F1 circuit? Well, here at Ultimate Drive, you can do just that and more. You've got three supercars to choose from: a Ferrari F430 F1 Spider and two Lamborghini Gallardos. I'm here with Mark, the Managing Director of Ultimate Drive. Tell me a bit about this car that I'm going to drive.
All right, it's a convertible Ferrari. It goes over 300 km per hour, but we are not going to try this today. Shall we go?
Oh my gosh, that sounded great. Okay, so we belt up and we're off.
The great thing about Ultimate Drive is that you don't have to choose only one car. You can try them all. And if you come with friends, you can drive side by side and swap cars halfway. A great way to get a feel of these Italian legends.
A great way to explore the city center is to get on the Marina Bay Segway Tours. You just hop on one of these and take off. What a leisurely way to tour the Marina Bay area. It's so easy, you get to enjoy the cool breeze. It's perfect. Come on, you gotta catch up. This is awesome. Wait for me. We're now heading towards Gardens by the Bay. Check out the super trees. Look at our skyline, it's so beautiful. You've got the Playa, you've got Gardens by the Bay, you've got Marina Bay Sands. It's so nice. That was awesome. I saw some of the best parts of the Marina Bay area here in Singapore, and I'll definitely do it again. One way to see the city is from the sky, on board the world's highest observation wheel, the Singapore Flyer. On a clear day like today, you can see the entire island. Don't miss the chance to experience the past and present of Asia at Singapore's award-winning museums. Remember, you can save more than 50% off museum admission fees when you purchase the 3-day museum pass. When
Welcome to Singapore's sunny island of Sentosa. A short train, bus, taxi, or even a cable car ride from the city. It's a one-stop holiday destination and home to dozens of attractions, restaurants, bars, beaches, places to stay, and countless opportunities to have some fun in the sun. What's more, enter here along the Sentosa Boardwalk and it's free! The state of fun is full of exciting attractions with great views. See the island from up high at Tiger Sky Tower. Have a mind-bending experience at the Trick Eye Museum. Adventure through the history of Singapore at Images of Singapore Live. Take a selfie with your favorite stars at Madame Tussauds Singapore and explore the creatures beneath the waves at Underwater World Singapore and Dolphin Lagoon. But where better to start your Sentosa adventure than at the icon of Singapore? The Sentosa Merlion is a mythical half-lion, half-man creature that symbolizes our strength and prosperity. Get a stunning 360-degree view of the island from the summit and take home your very own prosperity coin, a great memento of your day and your time in Singapore. Before Sentosa became the state of fun, it played an important role in Singapore's history. Now the fort has multimedia exhibits that recreate the drama of time, as well as the nation's largest collection of World War II memorabilia. Nature lovers have to go to the Butterfly Park, where you can catch butterflies emerging from their cocoons, watch them fly around you, and meet some colorful feathered friends as well. A fun and eco-friendly way to get around Sentosa is on a Segway. Segway Tours offers guided scenic tours around the island. Glide around Siloso, Palawan, and Tanjung Beach and explore places you never knew existed. If you have kids, you should definitely take them here to the Port of Lost Wonder. They've got an awesome play area that the kiddos love, and the adults can sit down and have a glass of beer and chill out. Even if you don't have kids, you should come to their restaurant called the Pork Belly. Delicious food, I tell you. Adrenaline junkies have to try Mega Zip, an adventure park with some of the most extreme zip lines in Asia. I Fly Singapore, where you can simulate jumping out of a plane and literally flying through the air, and 4D Adventureland with four high-tech interactive adventures in one location. One attraction you simply can't miss is the Skyline Luge, which offers an action-packed descent through the forest to the beach along two different courses. Also worth a splash is Wave House Sentosa, where the adventurers can learn to surf and others like me can relax with a drink and watch the pros in action. Wave House Sentosa is now also home to Sea Breeze Water Sports, which offers jet-packed flights, banana boat rides and more. Just along Siloso Beach is the Flying Trapeze, another spot for thrill seekers. And when night falls, taking the dazzling Wings of Time show, set outdoors against the backdrop of an open sea with water, laser and fire effects set to majestic music. After all that fun, Sentosa is a great place to just chill with plenty of excellent bars and restaurants. For authentic Asian food, try Taste of Asia at the Beach Station, which serves fantastic food from all over Asia. And for that laid-back beach vibe, Seaside has three great locations right on Siloso Beach, with Coasts, Sandbar, Flame, Makan Makan, and the famous Bikini Bar, offering a varied selection of dining and drinking options. And for a fitting end to a perfect day, take a stroll along the Sentosa Boardwalk and enjoy the cool sea breeze and magnificent views of the harbour. It's a memorable ending to a fun day on Sentosa.
Behind why the Singapore sling was invented?
Same reason everything invented, law. Horny man tried to torture a hot girl.
The show is called Singapore Stripped. It's a comedy roast. It covers Singapore's history from the moment Raffles stepped on shore, and it goes all the way up to the modern day.
Where are you from?
From the UK.
From the UK!
Welcome back. Please don't colonize us again.
All of the jokes we make have been approved by the government a bit. Not really, I'm just kidding.
Because so unusual to see such a large crescent on an Asian man, eh, Cindy?
People come to the shows and they really, really like the shows. They're really, really enjoying it. We get Singaporeans, we get expats, we get tourists. If you like your history with laughs, then come and see our show. If you don't come and see it.
Get ready to laugh out loud with Cindy Fong and Crispy at the Palauna Bar, Clarke Quay for Singapore Strip, running from 1st April to 20th June. Tickets are available at cystic.com.sg. Have a newfound appreciation for England's famous playwright with Shakespeare in the Park's The Tempest at the Fort Canning Park from 29th April to 24th May. Tickets may be purchased at cystic.com.sg. Watch London's longest-running comedy play, No Sex Please, We're British, at the Jubilee Hall of the Raffles Hotel from 6th to the 16th of May. For ticket inquiries, visit cystic.com.sg.
You know, a lot of people are under the misapprehension that there's not much happening in Singapore. Nothing could be further from the truth. This city rocks. You've got Marina Bay, you've got the new Botanical Gardens, you've got the Bird Park, one of the world's best zoos, the Singapore Flyer, and multiculturalism. That's what I love. It brings so much culture, so much food. Little India, Chinatown, got the Thai Quarter around here, and this is the Arab Quarter, Arab Street, where you get some of the best Egyptian and Middle Eastern food, nasi padang, oh, I think falafel, kibbeh. Enough with cream, that's what I want. I'm so hungry.
Eating is Singapore's national obsession. From the country's top tables and exclusive restaurants to the vibrant hawker centres that cover the city state, the energy and devotion that Singaporeans have for their local cuisine is second to none. If you want to strike up a conversation with a local, just ask where the best wonton noodle store is or who makes the spiciest chili crab.
Singapore is well known for its selection of iconic hawker centres, but none is so impressive as the queen of the crop, Lau Pa Sat.
Located in the middle of the central business district, Lau Pa Sat is housed in the former Telok Ayer Market, a cast iron Victorian structure shipped out from Scotland in the 19th century. When the market was moved elsewhere, the site became a food centre and has remained as one of the city's finest ever since. Lau Pa Sat offers a wide selection of local delicacies and international choices. The good news is that Lau Pa Sat has just undergone a major renovation and now offers more seating, vastly improved ventilation, and a wider selection of local and international cuisines to whet your appetite. It still remains true to its history though, making it a fascinating place to visit. As always, look for the cues to discover what's good here.
I've scoured the stalls here for some of my favourite dishes. I've got the Singapore favourite chicken rice, the Vietnamese rice paper rolls, and the thunder tea rice. And there's also some Turkish wrap, fried Hokkien Mee, delicious fishball noodles, and of course, iced kacang. Where do I start? Another improvement after the renovation is Quay 18, a relaxing place to have a cold drink and watch the world go by.
Perhaps one of the highlights of Lau Pa Sat in the evenings is the great selection of satay available here when Boon Tat Street is closed to traffic.
Dining al fresco here is the perfect way to end the day. Beef, chicken and mutton satay. You should check out all the other local delights as well, like sambal stingray, chili crab, roti john, and if you want something western, they even have spaghetti with a homemade meatball. Wash all this down with beer. Absolutely perfect.
Whether you choose to eat inside or out, a visit to Lau Pa Sat should be on everyone's itinerary. If Singapore is a food capital, then Lau Pa Sat is very much its beating heart. Bon appétit! You're watching Insider TV, the insider's guide to the world's most exciting cities.
For a journey back to the glamour of the 1920s, check out the Black Swan, right smack in the middle of Singapore's central business district.
This stylish bistro restaurant and bar stands in a restored Art Deco building with a spacious bar and dining area on the ground floor and a more private cocktail lounge, the Powder Room, upstairs.
Start your evening with a glass of champagne, a bespoke cocktail, and a dozen oysters before tucking into bistro favorites like the duck leg confit or the famous Black Swan Burger. Upstairs here in the Powder Room, they have a great selection of craft beers, single malts and fine wines, as well as my personal favourite, Goodnight Peru. It's absolutely delicious.
Over Easy is a tastefully designed homage to the American diner that blurs the lines between drinking and dining.
Expect a menu of great favorites from the states like milkshakes, cold beer, and exclusive all-American cocktails in a great setting inspired by classic American diners.
Over Easy's location is also hard to beat, right on the water with a stunning view of the majestic towers of Marina Bay Sands.
Try the burgers and their legendary spicy wings, washed down with a milkshake as the sun sets on Marina Bay.
And of course, don't miss the amazing Marina Bay light show from the very best seats in the house.
Conveniently located on the 55th floor of Ion Orchard on Orchard Road, Singapore's premier shopping belt, Luke Mangan's Salt Grill and Sky Bar is perched seemingly in the clouds.
With a 180-degree view of the city from the highest point on Orchard Road, it offers spectacular views of the island and beyond. Salt Grill serves Luke Mangan's creative take on modern Australian cuisine, where the freshness and quality of the ingredients is paramount. Signature dishes include sashimi of kingfish, ginger, eschalot and goat's feta, and the glass Sydney crab omelette with enoki mushroom, herb salad and a miso mustard broth.
It's the perfect place to watch the Singapore sunset as the night falls. I would advise arriving early for sundowners at the Sky Bar and free flow of champagne over stunning views of the sunset.
The location really comes into its own in the evenings though, so come for dinner as well.
We're here at Level 33, the world's highest urban craft brewery. This elegant bar and restaurant is a must visit for its range of fantastic traditional craft beers, all brewed brilliantly on the premises. I'm with Martin Bem at the city's ultimate rooftop bar, Level 33. Tell me a bit more about your beers.
This is our best-selling beer, that's the lager, based on a Viennese recipe. A pale ale. Pale ale is originating from England. This is our porter. Porter is the origin of stout. And then, of course, our very dark, chocolatey, coffee-colored stout.
Let's get into your menu. What food goes well with what beer?
Generally speaking, you could say that the lighter beers, like the lager and the pale ale, go better with lighter food, like fish or white meat. And the darker beers accompany very well stronger dishes like game or our lamb shoulder.
Level 33 offers more than craft beers. Executive chef Jimmy Tuganin's creative beer-infused menu of modern European dishes is well recognized by culinary enthusiasts.
The dishes in the beer dining section of Level 33's menu is the perfect accompaniment to their range of delicious signature beers. But if beer isn't your tipple, you're in luck. Level 33 also has a fantastic selection of wine.
My favorite dish? The lamb banjo. Meant for sharing. Maybe a little too big for me, but I'm going to give it a go.
The lamb banjo is a prime cut of Australian Dorper lamb, slow roasted on the bone, not to be found anywhere else in Singapore. For a unique dining experience, try Level 33 Marina Bay Financial Centre.
When in Singapore, Faber Peak Singapore is a must visit. When it comes to alfresco dining, nowhere else offers the kind of views and the unique range of food options as Faber Peak Singapore. Spuds and Aprons is a casual and chilled out dining spot. I always go for the chili crab in a tuck and the jar of happiness. A 5-minute walk away from Faber Peak, Faber Bistro is a great place to relax and rejuvenate. Also, there are great views for you to take in as you eat good food. But the most unique dining experience is undoubtedly the Singapore Cable Car Sky Dining.
Choose from 3 or 4 course meals on board this private cable car cabin as you watch the sunset.
Eating is Singapore's national pastime, so of course our local delicacies here are absolutely delicious. There are a few dishes that I think you need to try. Chicken rice, curry, Malay curry and Indian curry, roti prata, satay, and of course all the seafood. You've got grilled stingray, you've got things like tiger prawns, chili crab. The perfect place to eat all this wonderful seafood is here at Quayside Seafood at Clarke Quay. You get amazing views of the Singapore River and, of course, delicious food. That is amazing. This, ladies and gentlemen, is our national dish, the chili crab. This is one whole crab, by the way. It comes in a rich chili sauce. It's quite spicy and generally, you know, it gets quite messy when you eat chili crab, but that's actually the fun part. The best part of the chili crab has to be the claw. Ta-da! And you know what you should do? You should pour more sauce over this chunk of crab meat right here, like that, and then use your hands and, well, dig in.
Grilled to perfection. Check out how big this piece of prawn is. I'm gonna dip it in the special sauce and eat it. Boats going past in the sunset, cool breeze on my face, tuck it into delicious seafood. Life is good here in Singapore. They say it's the most important meal of the day, and I have to say, I couldn't agree more.
Wild Honey offers more breakfast options than anywhere else in Singapore. Their menu brims with authentic breakfast specialties from all over the world, served all day, every day. International favorites, as well as a good selection for the more adventurous. Turkish breakfasts, Parisian French toast, Barbary confit duck hash, and more.
I've decided to go for the Norwegian. Avocado, asparagus, poached egg and smoked salmon with hollandaise sauce all over on a whole wheat brioche. Healthy and delicious.
Wild Honey has two locations, on the top level of Scott Square with a great balcony for alfresco dining and their big new space in Mandarin Gallery, which has an unbeatable view overlooking Orchard Road. Right next door to Wild Honey and Mandarin Gallery, check out the only authentic New York deli in Singapore.
Sasha & Sons showcases authentic recipes of New York's iconic delis. Think incredibly juicy smoked pastrami, latkes and smoked salmon, not to mention traditional bagels handmade every day. Try their scrambled eggs, caramelized onions and smoked salmon bagel together with a nice cup of Common Man Roasters coffee.
Open every day from 10 a.m. till late, Sasha's is a little taste of New York in the heart of Orchard Road.
Clarke is well known as the hub of nightlife here in Singapore. Among the many clubs and bars, Pump Room's prime location next to the fountain makes it one of the most popular.
Slap bang in the middle of Clarke, Pump Room is hard to miss. It has become a local favorite as an after-work hangout for those wanting to dance the night away, serving cocktails, drinks and a wide selection of Western food.
And not to mention the Pump Room's pièce de résistance, their award-winning range of craft beers, brewed on-site with only four ingredients: grain, hops, yeast, and water. Cheers!
Ladies get free flow of featured drinks every Wednesday.
Their menu of Aussie favourites provide the perfect start to a night on the town.
From tempura and pizzas to fresh grilled steaks and braised lamb shank, Pump Room's menu pairs perfectly with their beers and cocktails.
After you've had your fill, head to the dance floor to party the night away.
Pump Room's resident band and DJs play modern hits and classic anthems to keep you going until the early hours. Indulge in a sensational dining experience at Shiraz, Singapore's best choice for authentic Persian cuisine. Located at dynamic Clarke, Shiraz offers comfortable dining both inside or alfresco. With nightly entertainment, Shiraz is an ideal location for either taking out business clients or a relaxed social get-together. You're watching Insider TV, the insider's guide to the world's most exciting cities.
I'm Justin Brad.
And tonight, we're going to be your Insider TV nightlife guides right here in Clarke. There's so much to do, so I think we should get started.
Let's make this happen.
Let's do it. Clarke used to be a hub for boats to dock, but now there are trendy bars and restaurants and clubs where there's so much to see.
It's all happening right now. We're here at Full House Signature, and I believe the great thing about this place is they have a unique interior and they're also known for their cocktails. Oh my goodness gracious.
Wow, that was amazing. If you like cocktails, tacos, then you have to come here. Is this what you call dessert?
Yes.
Salud.
Right here where this fountain is where New Year's Eve, Halloween, and Oktoberfest all go down.
And it's not only that, we have all these amazing bars around here. We have Highlander, Pump Room, Aquanova, and Mulligan's, where you can people watch and have a drink and have a good time. So I think we should get our drink on. Where should we go first?
Let's go this way.
Pump Room, awesome.
I need a quick bite to eat. Let's hop on over to a place with great gourmet hot dogs and craft beer. It's called Hot Dog.
Oh my gosh, these are huge.
We're here right outside Kuro, where you can find good Japanese food, cocktails, dancing, and a live band.
This place is a little bit different.
If you're craving some Indian food, some cider and beer, then this is the place to be.
Cheers.
Cheers. Mmm, that is good. We're halfway through our night and the crowd is pumping here.
There is definitely a lot of energy going on right now. And this type of energy, it makes me want to
dance.
What better place to dance at right now? Have fun.
Are you excited? Because I'm super excited.
I'm super excited because every time you have a favorite place, we have a good time.
So we just ended our night here at Clark Quay, which was so fantastic. What did you think?
Absolutely amazing.
But I think we should go to one more place before we leave. What do you think? Kebabs? Ice cream?
How about kabobs?
Kabobs? All right, let's do it.
Kebab and ice cream.
The St. Petersburg Ballet Company performs Swan Lake for the first time in Singapore at the Sands Theatre, Marina Bay Sands, from the 28th to the 31st of May. For more information, visit cystic.com.sg. Listen to the greatest hits of Michael Bolton on the 28th of May at an evening with Michael Bolton in the Mastercard Theatre, Marina Bay Sands. For tickets, visit cystic.com.sg. Join Peppa Pig and friends as they journey to find treasure at Peppa Pig Live Treasure Hunt from 30th May to the 1st of June at the Resorts World Theatre in the Resorts World Sentosa. Tickets are available at cystic.com.sg.
The best place to get a real taste of Ireland without leaving the tropics is here at McGettigan's.
In a prime position on Clark Quay, McGettigan's is easy to get to, and with the modern facade and decor, it's also hard to miss. Love sports? Me too. McGettigan's is well set up with all of the world's top sporting events live on HD screens, and us girls will love the gorgeous interior, not to mention some of the best Irish and international live music and comedy acts live on stage.
Of course, I'm here for the award-winning Irish food. Needless to say, I've gone for the full Irish breakfast, which is served all day. It's not for the faint-hearted, but I think I'm more than up to the task.
McGettigan's dinner menu also has a wide range of authentic Irish and Western options, from black Angus sirloin steak to beer-battered fish and chips.
And of course, you cannot leave without having a pint of their famous black stuff, probably the best pint of Guinness in Singapore.
Open every night, Le Noir is a premium bar and nightclub in a prime location on the Singapore River, Clark Quay. My favorite night is Ladies' Night every Thursday, where ladies get up to 5 free drinks before midnight. A short stroll away is Bar Rose, part of one of Singapore's leading nightclubs, Attica. It's the perfect spot for pre-party drinks on the river, and their fresh fruit martinis are simply to die for. Then, head just opposite to Attica, where you can party on 2 floors of thumping beats until 5 a.m. every weekend. On Wednesday nights, ladies get in for free and receive up to 5 free drinks before midnight. People come from all over the world to shop here on Orchard Road. The world's biggest brands, independent labels and boutiques, department stores, bars, restaurants, and no fewer than 22 malls litter a 2-kilometer stretch. It's a haven for shopaholics, and it's my favorite place to shop in Singapore. At one mall, you can get your feet massaged, get your run analyzed, send a unique postcard home to a loved one, and even get the dead skin eaten from your feet by little fish. 313 at Somerset, right above Somerset MRT station, and a 5-minute stroll from Orchard MRT is more than just a shopping mall. With some of the world's top fashion labels, a section especially for sports enthusiasts, an indoor street of food outlets, and some unique services that set this mall apart. Before you start, to make life easier for yourself, get connected to the free Wi-Fi network and download Tring 313. It's a free location-based app that gives you personalized deals within the app itself, so you can purchase it and then pick up at concierge or the store itself. 313 at Somerset's retail outlets are spread over 8 levels, with a great range of modern fashion stores for young trendsetters. Fashion is well covered here, from international labels like Forever 21, Zara and Cotton On, to fantastic homegrown labels like Charles and Keith. The shoes are so glamorous, but so affordable. Level 4 is home to a great selection of sports stores, which offer a far greater range of sporting goods than the usual Orchard Mall. iRun is dedicated to those who love running, me included. From shoes and apparel, to more specialized products like running aids and cool gadgets to improve your run. For soccer fans, Goal at 313 stocks everything you can think of, including replica kits for our very own Singapore Lions. 313 at Somerset is also home to some unique services and experiences, spas, professional hair salons, not to mention the first scrapbook retail store of its kind in Southeast Asia, where you can make personalized, gorgeous postcards and cards to send home to loved ones. And when hunger hits, 313 has you covered with Food Republic on the top floor, with a focus on Asian cuisine and a unique cluster of restaurants and bars on the ground floor. Don't miss Marché, a Swiss-themed market-style restaurant with live cooking stations serving a huge range of authentic Swiss food. Before relaxing in one of the many bars along Discovery Walk on the ground level, it's a great place to meet friends, have a drink, have some dinner, and discuss purchases. IMM, Singapore's largest outlet mall, boasts 3 floors of retail and F&B spaces, providing quality and value for some of the world's most popular and renowned brands. With a vast array of outlet stores offering year-round discounts of up to 60%, IMM is just a free shuttle ride away from J-Cube and Westgate Mall and walking distance to Jurong East MRT station. And if all the shopping gets too much, more than 40 delectable food options serving up everything from international cuisine to local favorites provide the perfect means to take a break. Where better to start a day of shopping than here at one of my favorite brands, Coach? Coach Outlet has a wide selection of modern luxury accessories and lifestyle collections for men and women, all exclusive to Coach Outlet. Right next door, Anya Bay's first outlet store in Singapore features a specially created collection of outlet products exclusive to the store. Next stop, one of IMM's newest outlets. Garage is the Ziggler's latest concept outlet store. I just love the design in this place. The fashion outlet by JG has so many world-renowned brand names, I don't know where to start. Levi's, Cilio, Dockers, TM Lewin, New Look, Oshkosh Bagosh. The list goes on and it's all up to 70% off. Last but not the least on my whistle-stop shop at IMM is Sarkor Outlet. Sarkor Brothers' range of bespoke men's clothing is irresistible. It makes for the perfect gift for a friend or a loved one. Iga? Thank you. You just can't beat IMM for value. I must have saved a fortune here and on such great quality products. When you come to IMM, enjoy tourist special privileges for even greater savings. Just present your passport at the customer service counter on level 2 to collect your tourist privilege booklet. What's more, after shopping, hop on the free shuttle bus to further explore nearby shopping malls, J-Cube and Westgate.
IMM's vast range of outlet stores is unrivaled in Singapore. So to grab yourself a bargain, head over to IMM here at Jurong East today.
The day is still young for me. Next stop, the West's newest family and lifestyle shopping experience, Westgate.
As well as 7 floors of fashion, lifestyle and F&B outlets, Westgate is Singapore's only mall with Westgate Wonderland, the largest fantasy garden-themed outdoor playground especially for kids. And you can also leave your precious ones in safe hands at Westgate Kids Club while you shop to your heart's content. When hunger hits, enjoy a bite to eat at one of 60 dining options, from bakeries to cafes, both indoors and outdoors at the courtyard, where you can even catch a live band at the weekends and have a beer and chill out at Broadside.
My exciting day of retail therapy would not be complete until I've experienced the last and most unique mall on my itinerary.
Offering somewhat more than the usual shopping experience, J-Cube is a leisure and entertainment mall like no other. J-Cube is home to Singapore's first Olympic-sized ice skating rink with a 460-seat gallery. This 1,800 square meter skating rink on level 3 even hosts international events and competitions and weekly disco on ice nights. J-Cube is also home to a karaoke joint, Teo Heng, and Shaw IMAX Theatre, playing the latest Hollywood blockbusters in IMAX 3D. And on level 2, J Avenue, an ever-changing street shopping experience, has a diverse range of 70 trendy and affordable stores offering the latest fashion, accessories, gadgets and gifts. With over 600 stores, countless dining options and a whole range of attractions for the whole family, IMM, J-Cube and Westgate Malls together are a one-in-a-kind mega mall experience like no other in Singapore.
After a whole day's worth of serious shopping, I think I've definitely earned myself a rest. I can't wait to go through all my purchases at home. Singapore's bustling Orchard Road, Mandarin Gallery is a haven for the more discerning fashionista.
From fashion and jewelry to accessories and even furniture, Mandarin Gallery offers an amazing spread of quintessential boutiques as well as international brands. And when you're ready for a quick time out, a lip-smacking range of eateries await.
On the second level, there's Inhabit, the other store, which showcases high-end fashion labels like Dion Lee, Richard Nickel, and Josh Good.
Japanese designer Yohji Yamamoto has teamed up with legendary sports brand Adidas to produce an innovative collection of men and women's apparel with the perfect blend of functionality and Yamamoto's signature sense of style.
If, like me, you appreciate a beautiful watch, come into E Collezione's bespoke collections here at the first flagship boutique in Singapore.
The bold and seductive store is as luxuriously playful as the bespoke timepieces on display.
I am so in love with this one.
With exclusive distribution rights for some of the most unique Japanese furniture designers, the craftsmanship and attention to detail in Atomi's range of furniture is absolutely second to none.
Now this place really sets the Mandarin Gallery apart.
Artistic is a tea house, art gallery and workshop all rolled into one.
What do you think?
And after a long day of shopping, drinking tea, and of course, painting, make the most of Mandarin Gallery's array of delectable eateries that cater for every taste.
And what could be better than a well-earned cup of coffee and a slice of cake here at the Providor?
From innovative boutique concepts to renowned international labels, Mandarin Gallery is Singapore's most unique shopping mall and offers Asia's most luxurious one-stop shopping experience. Tune into next month's show for even more insider knowledge and remember, watch the whole show online every month on the Insider TV website and our dedicated YouTube channel.
There are many areas of historic importance in Singapore, but none are so important to Singapore's recent history as the Singapore River. Quite simply, this is where it all began.
As a port city, Singapore's now thriving economy was founded on the banks of the Singapore River back in the 19th century. The contrast between these colorful shop houses and the towering skyscrapers of the CBD behind is one of more iconic images of the Singapore cityscape. These days, government buildings still line the river's banks, but the port has long since moved to Tanjung Pagar, causing this historic series of quays to reinvent themselves as lively centers of history, culture, and Singapore's favorite pastime, food. From the Asian Civilizations Museum to the historic bridges, galleries, theaters, and shops that line the river, there's easily enough to keep you occupied for a whole day or two, so it's an ideal place to start your Singapore adventure. Occupying the almost 200-year-old building that was the original home to Singapore's parliament, the Arts House is the spiritual home for Singapore's vibrant art scene, playing host to literary arts, film, performing and visual arts and festivals.
Boki's collection of pubs and riverside restaurants make it a local favorite for after-work drinks and casual dining.
There are 13 adorable resident cats here at Niko no Niwa, the first cat cafe in Singapore. Whether you come for the cakes, coffee, or the kitties, Cat Cafe Niko no Niwa is the perfect place to unwind. The pecking order's eclectic vibe and kitschy furniture mix for a one-of-a-kind dining experience in Singapore. With great food, polite staff, and a cozy atmosphere, the pecking order is great for casual dinners in the city. Get your fish and chips fix with a side of Guinness at Molly Malone's. Interesting tidbit, the entire pub was built and designed on Ireland and then shipped and reassembled in Singapore to the Irish hangout we now know. Clarke Upstream is the epicenter of Singapore's nightlife, with an amazing selection of bars, restaurants and clubs partying late into the night. It's the place to be at New Year, Halloween, and Oktoberfest, but no matter what the occasion, there's always something going on. It's also a fantastic place for a relaxing lunch with a selection of very affordable deals at selected restaurants. Craving for seafood? Then hit up the Fremantle Seafood Market in Clarke Quay. The menu variety at Fremantle gives you a lot of dishes to choose from, including a fresh catch of crabs, oysters, mussels, clams, and shrimps. Ever heard about cooking your food on volcanic stone slabs? You can do exactly that at the Hot Stones restaurant at River Valley Road. This method of cooking makes every dish more juicy and flavorful, ensuring that every dish is a unique dining experience for their customers. Clarke Quay Central, a great place to shop, eat and unwind. I always recharge myself here with a coffee and watch the world go by.
Just a short ride away, Robertson Quay is the largest and most laid-back of the three quays and is a popular hangout for both the expat and local community.
There's a good choice of quality cafes, international restaurants and bars to choose from. Established in 1976, Red House specializes in Asian seafood dishes and Singaporean favorites. Using the freshest ingredients sourced globally, Red House seafood signature dishes are a big hit locally. Whether you're in Singapore for food or culture, to party or just to relax, the Singapore River has it all.